Eternal and all-wise Father, this morning as we come, we give you glory, honor, and praise. We magnify, edify, and exalt you, for you are the King of kings and the Lord of lords. We bless you now, Jesus, for your goodness, your mercy, and your grace. We repent of all sin and all iniquity, all ungodliness, and all unholiness. And Father, we ask you now to shift the atmosphere for your kingdom and for your glory. Shift us now that you'll be glorified and that you'll be exalted. We bind the powers of Satan and every spirit that will not give you all glory and all honor. Every spirit that will not give you all praise, we bind them by the power and the authority given. In Jesus' name, Father, we ask you to break the yokes of the enemy and release a fresh anointing even now. We pray for those that are sick and those that are seeking you for healing. We thank you for that anointing that heals and that anointing that breaks every yoke and that anointing that breaks every stronghold and release an apostolic authority, for your word is a standard against Satan. So we bind his power and we bind his authority. We bind every demonic attack, even in the airways. We break it by the power and the authority given in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We release that anointing from the north, the south, the east, and the west. We pray for the nations. We pray for America. We pray for your nation, Israel, and we bless her even now in the precious and mighty name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Thank you for being on this video this morning. It's Apostle Baron Spates. I want to speak to you for just a brief moment, and I want to deal with the anointing. And for those of you that may be taking notes on this message, I'm going to be coming out of Isaiah, and I'm only going to do one verse in Isaiah. That's Isaiah chapter 10, and I want to do verse 27. I want you to understand and to know that the word of God teaches us that God breaks the yokes. Jesus Christ breaks the yokes. The Holy Spirit breaks the yokes. And I say to you this morning that God says, I will break the yokes off of you. I will break the strongholds off of you. I will break the burdens, every stronghold that the enemy has on you. He says, my anointing makes the difference, and I'll break the yoke. Look at Isaiah chapter 10 and verse 27. It says, and it shall come to pass in that day that his burden shall be taken away from off thy shoulder, and his yoke from off thy neck, and the yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing. If you look at that particular verse, Isaiah, the prophet Isaiah, in this verse says, the day will come when the yoke that would be broken. There's one passage that says, come unto me, all you that are laden and heavy burden. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for my yoke is easy and my burdens are light. But you understand something. God is breaking yokes. The Holy Spirit is breaking strongholds. He's setting the captive free. And I want to say to you, those of you this morning or this afternoon that may be watching me, the yokes are being broken. The strongholds are being broken. Now, I want to say this. We know that there's a spiritual attack in the airway. We know about this coronavirus, and we know that it's nothing more than a demonic attack of Satan. No, God may not have created it, but he permitted it to be so. But at the same time, we know that greater is he that is in us than he that is in the world. And we also know and understand that when we surrender our will, when we surrender according to the voice of God and according to the word of God, that every yoke and every stronghold is broken. And I want to say one of the reasons that many of us still carry yokes and one of the reasons that many of us still carry strongholds is because we fail to surrender to the voice of God. We fail to obey what the Holy Spirit instructs us to do. And what the Father is saying to the body of Christ this morning is that, my sons and my daughters, I'm saying to you today that I'm breaking the yokes. I'm breaking the burdens. I'm setting the captive free. If you remember when the children of Israel were in prison in Egypt, God set them free, and when he set them free, one of the things that comes with freedom is the yoke of bondage is broken, and they were in bondage, and God broke the yoke of bondage. Some of you are in spiritual bondage, and it's going to take the Holy Spirit, the fire of God, the anointing of God, to break the bondage and the yoke off of you. And we're going to pray that once we get through with this word here in just a few moments. And look at Isaiah 10, 27. It says, and it shall come to pass in that day. We're living in the day, in the hour, now, where if there was ever time yokes and strongholds needed to be broken, we're living in that day, in that hour right now. And I know that there's some of you that's crying out to God, Lord, help me. Lord, save me. Lord, deliver me. Lord God, Jesus, please set me free. I don't know which way to turn. I don't know who to talk to. If that's you, I'm speaking to you this morning, and I have a word of the Lord for you. And he says, do not be troubled. Do not be dismayed. I have heard your cry, and I have already answered you. Remember when the Lord answered Cornelius? Cornelius prayed for 10 years for Israel to be saved. But when he prayed, it took 10 years for the angel to get to him. Let me tell you something. There are times when you're going through a storm and you're going through battles in your life, it may appear that it takes a long time to get the answer. But if you remain faithful, if you continue to be persistent, God will answer you. And for some of you this morning and this afternoon, I'm releasing the answer of the Lord. And it says, it shall come to pass in that day. We're living in that day now. We're living in that hour now where Jesus has died and rose with all power and all authority. He stripped Satan of his power. He stripped him of his authority. He rose from the dead with all power and all authority. And when he did that, he took the power and the authority from the grave. He took the sting of death from the grave. He stripped Satan of his authority. And what you've got to understand and realize is no demon can hold you now. No stronghold can hold you now. No attack from the north, the south, the east, and the west can hold you now. Why do you say that, Apostle? Because when Jesus rose and he got up with all power and he got up with all authority. The devil don't want you to know that you have power. He don't want you to know that through Jesus Christ, you have the authority. He don't want you to know that through Jesus Christ, every demon in the airway has to bow. Every stronghold and every yoke has to be lifted. See when the liberty of the Holy Spirit comes upon you, then the strongholds and the shackles of the enemy are crushed, they're destroyed. And then it says in that day, it says his burdens shall be taken away off of thy neck. So the word simply says in this verse that the day comes when the burdens and the yokes that you have been carrying on your neck shall be lifted off you. Remember I quoted the scripture, come unto me, all you that are laden and heavy burden. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me. One of the things you have to remember about that scripture, first of all, we've got to go to God. And when we go to him, he says, if you're burdened and you're heavy laden, he says, take my yoke and learn of me. So God says, I'm going to replace the yoke on your neck with my yoke. He says, take my yoke, take my wisdom, take my knowledge, take my understanding, take my burdens. In other words, what I have put on you, take it and learn. In other words, learn of me. In other words, whatever you're carrying, seek me, because in seeking me, I have the answer. Take my yoke and learn it. Now notice what God says. He says, take my yoke. In other words, it's not yours. It's not yours to carry. The burdens are not yours to carry. They belong to the Father. He says, as you carry these, learn of me. He says, because now my yoke is easier than the yokes and the burdens that you're carrying. My yoke is easy and my burden is light. So God says, it won't wear you down. He says, not only that, the reason it can be easy is because he will give you strategies. One of the things you have to understand about the anointing is the anointing breaks the yokes. But not only that, but he gives you strategies. Why is that, Apostle? Because he is the Holy Spirit. He is the fire of God. He comes forth with signs, wonders, and miracles and demonstrations through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. It says, now, his burdens shall be taken away. That means God is going to strip that burden. He's going to strip that yoke that you're carrying. He's going to strip it off of you. He says, off of your shoulders. So, you know, sometimes you pray for people, and sometimes I have the saints, they pray for people, and when they pray for them, I have them put their hands on their shoulders. And when I do, I tell them, I say, now I want you to lift like you're lifting every weight off of them. And sometimes the weights on them are so heavy that when they lift their hands, they fall backwards. And that's the immediate sign that whatever that yoke was that you were carrying just came off of you. Sometimes you can pray and all of a sudden you begin to feel light as a feather. Sometimes I was praying, remember I was praying for this woman of God, God bless her. And as I began to lift my hands, the Holy Spirit began to lift her straight up in the air. Just lifted her straight up. And she got all the way up till she was on her tippy toes. And the higher I went up, the higher she would go up. Why? Because God was lifting all the burdens. And what he's saying to you today that's looking at this video, he's saying, I'm lifting all your burdens. I'm lifting all your yokes. I came that you may have life and that you may have it more abundantly. I came to impart joy unspeakable within you. I came to give you eternal life. Let's look at the next verse in Isaiah chapter 10, 27. The second verse says, now we know the weights are moved off of your shoulders, the word says. It says, and his yoke from off of your neck. So not only does he break the burdens, but he takes the yoke off of your neck. Now, if you notice something, I want you to catch this. First of all, you can't see these because they're spiritual. You can't see them because they're spiritual. This is what you got to catch. He says, now you can't see anything on your neck, but you know it's there. You can feel it around your neck. You can feel the tension. You can feel the stress. That's the enemy. That's the attacks of the enemy. And you've got to get in the presence of God and begin to pray and begin to give him glory and begin to give him honor. And when you do that, those yokes and those strongholds that are on your neck will be broken immediately. And that's what Satan don't want you to know. He don't want you to know that you can be freed. But the anointing makes the difference. The anointing breaks the yoke. I thank God for Benny Hinn and for the book, The Anointing, because not only The Anointing, but the book, Good Morning, Holy Spirit. Those books shifted and changed my life. I've read them many, many times, over and over and over again. And there's so much power and so much authority in those books. If you just get them and read them and just allow the Holy Spirit to begin to shift you, allow God to begin to impart the Holy Spirit and allow him to impart the anointing. Because see, what happens when the Holy Spirit comes in, God begins to anoint you. And when he begins to anoint you, he begins to give you favor. And what the enemy don't want you to know is that you can have favor with God. He don't want you to know that you can be free from the shackles and the strongholds of his attacks. So we give God glory, honor, and praise that the anointing makes a difference. Now look at this verse. The second part, it says, and his yoke, that's the yoke of the enemy. That's the demonic forces. That's the attacks of the Satan. It says, the yoke of the enemy and his yoke from off thy neck. Now notice what the next verse says. And the yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing. So what God says in this verse, and what the word of God says in this verse, is not only will the yoke be broken and lifted, but it will be destroyed. Now let me tell you something about something that is destroyed. It's obliterated. And if you stay in the presence of the Lord, the enemy will never, ever again be able to bring that burden back. If you find yourself free from something and you find yourself back in it, doing it over and over again, it's not because you didn't pray and believe God, but it's because you didn't position yourself to stay in the presence of God. And as a result of that, the enemy can come back. And not only will he bring that yoke, but he will bring many more yokes and many more burdens. There are folks sitting in houses today. They're sitting in churches today, and they're burdened down. They're bound. And they can't seem to get free. And it appears that nothing they do works. And the reason is because they're burdened and they're bound. And it's nothing more than demonic attacks. It's nothing more than strongholds of Satan. But I tell you today that the fire of the Holy Ghost and the anointing will break every stronghold. The anointing will break every yoke of the devil. If you just begin to cry out to God and say, Lord, I've been carrying this weight and I've been trying to manage it myself. But your word teaches me today that you are the yoke breaker. You're the one that removes the strongholds off of my shoulders and off of my neck. And then begin to say, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, I give this burden to you. I give this yoke to you. You are my Savior. You are my Lord. You're my King of Kings. You're my all in all. The Bible says that the Holy Spirit breaks yokes and it destroys yokes. And I believe, God, through your word in Isaiah chapter 10, that the stronghold on me can be broken off of me. I believe that I can be delivered from every yoke of the enemy, every stronghold of the enemy. It doesn't matter whether it's an addiction. It doesn't matter what it is. The Holy Spirit will break it. The word says that if you take the yoke of God, he says his yoke is easy and his burdens are light. That means God won't wear you down. And that means that when you're going through, now notice it also says, and I'm not reading the verse, I'm quoting it, but it also says, take my yoke upon you. So in other words, you got to reject the yoke of the enemy. and receive the word of God. You got to reject the stronghold of the enemy and receive the word and the wisdom and the knowledge of God. Because guess what? That word and that wisdom and that knowledge of God, as it begins to fill you, every yoke and every spirit that's unlike God has to come off. Every stronghold has to be released. Every yoke has to be broken. If you're stressed in your neck and you just move and you're stressed, sometimes I remember years ago I used to work in the mortgage industry, and I was a senior loan officer, and there was a young lady that worked with us, God bless her, and she would walk around the office, and you know, when you're sitting at that desk all day long, you become tense, and she would just walk around the offices, a masseuse, and she would just massage your shoulders, and she would massage your neck, and when she massaged you, you could just feel that tension and that stress from that hard day of work coming off of you. Let the Holy Spirit massage you. Let him just feel you. And when she would take her hands and she would push in your back, and she knew exactly how to do it, and when she did it, it would just break the strongholds. It would just break the yokes. In other words, you just felt light as a feather, and you felt like you could go work another 5 or 6 hours straight because she did it so skillfully. Let me tell you something. The Holy Spirit moves in a skillful way, and he sees what you don't see. He moves in a way that he can get every serpent. He can get every scorpion, every snake, seed, root, and fruit. I know you don't like those words. But let me tell you something. Spiritual attacks bind you. Spiritual attacks hold you in captivity. And what God is saying in the word today is, I want to set you free. I want to deliver you from the strongholds of the enemy. I want to set you free from the attacks of Satan. I want to lift the burdens off of you so that I get the glory, so that I get the honor, so that I get the praise. This is what the Holy Spirit is saying. So he says, that yoke shall be destroyed by the anointing and because of the anointing. I go in churches and I see many people and they're so bound. And you know, sometimes I'm standing there and I'm waiting on the man of God to release the Holy Spirit to go forth and do what he wants to do to set the people free. But some of them are so filled with pride and so arrogant that even when the Holy Spirit and when God come in the house, they won't allow the Holy Spirit to flow and set the people free. And see, God sends his women servants, and he sends his man servant. Anytime a man of God, or anointed woman of God, or anointed man of God, just all of a sudden show up in your house, in many cases, not going to say every case, but in most cases, God has come to either bring a message to that house, and he comes to set the captive free with the power of the Holy Spirit and the power of the anointing. And sometimes we have to realize and understand that I may not walk in that realm, but if the Lord sends someone that you know walks in that realm into your congregation or into your ministry, you should allow the Holy Spirit, not the man of God, but the Holy Spirit within them. And you will know when God is speaking to you, because he'll tell you to release the woman of God or the man of God to go forward and allow the Holy Spirit to do what needs to be done in that house. Because obviously if God is sending them, he's sending them to bring a blessing. See, when God shows up, he comes to bless. When God shows up, he comes to increase. When God shows up, he comes to shift the burden and to bring a new impartation and a new activation and a new release of the anointing over that house. So don't be offended when the Holy Spirit show up, but receive what God is having. Because anytime God shows up, he comes to bless. Now, there are times he will come and he will bring a rebuke. But for the most part, he comes to bless. Because the prophetic is the word. The prophetic word lifts you. It builds you. It was not designed to destroy you. Sometimes I listen to prophets, and sometimes when they release the word, they release it in such a mean way, in such an arrogant and authoritative way that they make that word personal, which means it's instead of it flowing through the love of the Holy Spirit, it's flowing through their flesh. And see, one of the things I learned at Dr. Bill Hammond's church was how to release the Holy Spirit with love. How to release the word of God with love so that word shifts you. Now don't misunderstand, Apostle, because I am firm and I am strong and I stand bold in the things of God. But when it comes to releasing a word of the Lord, I try to give you that word where, through the Holy Spirit, where that word build you, where that word shift you. And as leaders, that's what we should be doing. We should be releasing that word where it builds the body of Christ and not where it tears the body of Christ down. I want to give you some scriptures this morning. So bear with me just a moment as I begin to go into these scriptures. Isaiah 37 and 35 says, "And I will defend this city to save it for my own sake and for my servant David's sake. Now God says in this particular verse, and he talks about the anointing in this particular passage of scripture, he says, I'm going to defend the city. And when I defend this city, he says, I'm going to defend it for my own sake. See, the anointing comes for the sake of God. It doesn't come for so much. It comes to set you free, but it's ordained and it's ordered by God. Not only is it ordained and it's ordered by God, but when the Holy Spirit shows up, every demon and every stronghold that's holding you has to be broken. See, God defends you. In other words, see, when the enemy rises up against you, God will come and he will lift up a standard against Satan. And when he lifts up that standard, guess what Satan has to do? He has to let you go. He can no longer hold you. I want to deal with one verse that deals with just bear with me just a second. So he says in that verse, he says, I will defend. So see, God is your defense. He is your defender. Not only that, but he does it for his sake, for what he's ordained and for what he's called you to. See, if the enemy has you bound, the will of God cannot come forth. If the enemy is holding you in captivity, the will of God cannot come forth. Why? Because God has a plan. God has a purpose. I want to read another one for you. Psalms 2, 1, 2, 3 says, why do the heathen rage and the people imagine a vain thing? The kings of the earth set themselves, and the rulers take counsel together against the Lord and against his anointed, saying, let us break their bands asunder and cast away their cords from us. And God says in the word, not so. He says, I want you to know that the attacks come from the rulers. Now, demonic forces in the airway, spiritual attacks in the airway will rise against you, but they come at you through people. They come at you through those that are in authority. They come at you through arrogancy and pride. They come at you through different types of racism and things of that nature. But we know the Bible says they that worship God must worship him in spirit and in truth. In other words, so God is not a God of racism. Racism should not be in the house of God. Because guess what? God is a God of spirit. He's a God of many nations. And guess what? Since he's a God of spirit and he's a God of many nations, he does not deal with us from the fleshly perspective. He deals with us from the spiritual perspective, simply meaning he discerns our spirit. He looks at what's working in our spirit. See, the natural eye judges the flesh, but the Holy Spirit and the anointing judge the spirit. Now, catch what I'm saying. So when the Holy Spirit and the anointing judge the spirit, one of the things that the Holy Spirit and the anointing sees, the Holy Spirit and the anointing of God, one of the things it sees is it sees the demonic attacks that are attached to your spirit. It sees the strongholds that are attached to your spirit. And guess what it does? It goes to battle to set you free. That's why the anointing can destroy demons. That's why the Holy Spirit and the fire of God can destroy demons. See, when you say, Father, let your Holy Ghost and fire consume me, burn up everything that's unlike you. When you begin to surrender your all, then the Holy Spirit and the anointing begins to consume it. And see, what the enemy don't want you to know is how to get free. But not only that, how to stay free. Because see, one of the ways you stay free is by staying in the presence of God. Staying in the presence of the Holy Spirit, making it your business before you run out your door every morning. You need to set a time to get in the presence of the Lord and allow the Holy Spirit to begin to pour upon you. Allow the fire of God to begin to pour upon you every day. Make it a daily thing. You notice one of the things I do when I get on my calls is I always repent for sins and iniquity. And one of the reasons I do that is because the Bible says, repent of your sins daily, for you know not when you have sinned. And sometimes we can sin unawarely. But when you get in the presence of the Holy Spirit and he really begins to change you and the anointing comes and he really begins to shift you, it becomes automatic. Why? Because when you move, you want to move freely. You don't want to be bound, but you want to be able to freely move. And when you freely move, the power of God can flow and the enemy that's holding people, the shackles can be broken off of them. A couple of more verses and we're going to stop for this morning. Psalms 2. Oh, I'm sorry. Let me go back. The Lord said I'm missing something. I want you to look at Psalms 2, and look at verse number 2. It says, the kings of the earth set themselves, and the rulers, now see, that's physical, take counsel together. They plot together. We got a lot of plotting together going on right now against the people of God. Not only, but see, even though they're physical conversations, they're spiritual attacks. Sometimes we can be so high and so mighty that nobody can tell us anything. We're watching this manifest and unfold before our eyes right now in our government. Sometimes we can be so arrogant that we think we know everything. And in most cases, nobody can speak to us or nobody can tell us anything. And even when they tell us, we go the opposite direction. We're watching this manifest in our government before our very eyes. It is amazing how God is beginning to open the eyes of the saints and the eyes of the people to see how the spirit and how the enemy can literally destroy you because you will not allow yourself to shift or to change because you are stuck in your ways. And sometimes when we become stuck in our ways, it is hard to change. But we have to allow the Holy Spirit to change us. See, when you reject wisdom, when you reject knowledge, that's a dangerous thing. When you reject seeking God, that's a dangerous thing. Because see, one of the things wisdom is the Holy Spirit. And God has people all around us that's full of wisdom, full of knowledge. I'm in training. I'm in school right now, learning more things. Why? Because I know that it benefits the body of Christ. Because I know that one day somebody may come up to me and ask me something in this area, and I'll be able to give them insight. I'll be able to give them information, or I'll be able to direct them to the source that they can find the information that they're looking to. It's not always about knowing everything. It's not always about having the answer to everything. We don't know everything. That's why God put powerful people around us. So in return, we can use their knowledge. We can use their strategies. See, when you work together, see, God calls the body of Christ into unity. That means oneness. And the reason he does that is because he expects the body of Christ to work as one. And how do we know that? Well, that's the reason the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit are one. They work together, although they have different offices and although they have different assignments. They have different spiritual assignments. The Holy Spirit equips you. He's the anointing of God. Jesus is the man of God manifested in the flesh. He's the Savior of the whole world. And the Heavenly Father is the kingdom of the entire universe. He's the king, correction, of the entire universe. He's over it all. He's over it all. And for that, God gets all the glory. For that, God gets all the honor. For that, God gets all the praise. We glorify, we magnify, we edify, and we exalt the King of Kings. Why? Because God wants you and I to know that I am your enablement. I am your strength. I am your joy. And don't be deceived by the attacks of the enemy, of the rulers of this world. See, counsel means they sit down and they plot and they plan. That's what counsel means together. Against the Lord and against his anointing. That means they were, let me tell you something. You can rise against God, but you are no match for God. You were defeated before you ever started. Why? Because God already knew what you were going to do. He already knew your actions even before they manifested. He says, against the anointed. That means those that are the sons and the daughters of the kingdom of God. The enemy plots and he plans against them. I want you to look at Psalms 20 and verse number 6. It says, now I know that the Lord saveth his anointed. See, God comes and he saves his anointed. He will hear him from his holy heavens with the saving strength of his right hand. See, God saves his anointed. See, and notice he says, when you anointed, God hears you in the heavens. See, the anointing breaks the yokes in the atmosphere. It breaks demonic forces in the atmosphere. See, when the anointing is on you, the fire of God is on you. The lightning of God is on you. When the anointing is on you, you are like a flame of fire. You're like the fire and of the Holy Ghost. That's what's on you. And see, what happens is when you begin to pray and God begins to anoint you, that anointing just increases. It just intensifies. Why? Because see, demons are not going to come at the anointed because they know that they're no match for the anointed. They know that they're no match for the fire of God. And see, the anointing breaks the yoke. So notice what it says in that verse. It says, now I, it says, correction, Now know I that the Lord saveth his anointed. He will heal him from his holy heavens with the saving strength of his right hand. See, God goes to battle for you. He dispatches the angels to fight on your behalf. God is your battle. See, he told Jehoshaphat, he said, the battle is not yours. It belongs to the Lord. Psalms 45 and verse number 7 says, thou lovest righteousness and hatest wickedness. Therefore, thou God, hath anointed thee with the oil of gladness above thy fellows. So now, notice what God says. He says, because you love righteousness. See, one of the things the anointing does, it draws you to righteousness. It draws you to holiness. It draws you to godliness. And because you allow it to draw you, God can bring a shift. Because you allow it to draw you, God can bring gladness. He can bring happiness. He can bring joy, victorious joy. So even in your burdensome hour, even when the enemy try to keep you burdened or try to keep you bound, guess what God says? Because of the anointing, I set you free. Psalms 87. I want to read just a couple here. Look at the very first one. Psalms 87, 20. Psalms 87, I'm on verse 20, but I want to start with Psalms 87, 20 through 52. And verse 20 says, I have found David my servant, with the oil have I anointed him. God says, I found David my servant. See, we're servants of God, and with the oil God will anoint us. Remember when the prophet found Jesse, and he was looking for a king. And when his sons came up, and the prophet said, no, it's not this one, no, it's not this one. And he had checked all of them, and I'm paraphrasing. He said, no, it ain't none of those. And he asked Jesse, he said, do you have another son? And Jesse said, I have one working in the field. David was in the field mending the sheep. See, when God is calling you to greatness, he humbles you. When he's calling you to greatness, he prepares you. Think about it. He keeps you meek. Because when he's calling you to greatness, he begins to pour in you and he begins to shift you for his glory and for his kingdom. And see, David was in the field mending sheep, but David was going to be the next king. But see, if the prophet wasn't persistent and asked Jesse, did he have another son, we would not know of David today. Look at the next verse. It says, with whom my hand shall establish, mine arm also shall strengthen him. See, the anointing establishes you. The anointing strengthens you. So when the enemy attacks you, the anointing is what covers you, the Holy Spirit. It strengthens you. It brings about establishment. It means it puts you in a place of establishment, or in other words, you become founded. It lays the groundwork for the foundation. See, what the enemy don't want you to be is established. He don't want you to understand that once you get the anointing, you have the power and the authority over Satan. He don't want you to know that once you get the anointing, he no longer has authority. I want you to look at the next verse. Verse number 22 in Psalms 89, chapter 20. 22 says, the enemy shall not exact upon him, nor the son of wickedness afflict him. See, God says, when the anointing comes, Satan is powerless. When the anointing comes, the yokes of Satan are broken. When the anointing comes, the strongholds of Satan are broken off of you. And the reason they're broken is because Satan is no match for the Father. He's no match for God. And this is the reason he has no authority over you. When you surrender. See, so you say, now Lord, break the anointing. Break the strongholds off of me. But see, when the anointing comes, it breaks it. But you've got to stay in the place where God can continue to bless you. Look at verse number 23 in Psalms 89 and 20. It says, and I will beat down his foes before his face and plague them that hate him. God says, because they rise up against you, not only am I going to cover and protect you, but I'm going to beat down your enemy, which is Satan, the devil. I'm going to beat down your serpent. No, it's not the people. Don't misunderstand. Spirits operate through people. But when they're delivered, they come into the place of God, they can be some of the most beautiful people you've ever seen. But strongholds can make them envious. Strongholds of control, strongholds of hatred, strongholds of malice and envy and strife and jealousy. Those are strongholds. Those are demonic forces. Those are spiritual witchcraft attacks. Witchcraft, the spirit of witchcraft, the spirit of control. These are attacks of the devil that's operating through people. It's not necessarily so much the people, but it's the attack of the enemy. One more verse and we're finished. Look at verse number 24. It says, but my faithfulness and my mercy shall be with him, and in my name shall his horn be exalted. God says, see, I'm gonna remain faithful. I'm not going to fail him. I'm not going to let him down. I'm going to stay with him. Look at verse 28. I'm going to drop down for just a moment. It says, my mercy will I keep for him forever, and my covenant shall stand fast with him. See, God makes a covenant with you, with the anointing. He makes a covenant, and he will not leave you. He will not forsake you. He will be there. Look at what he says in verse number 30. He says, if my children forsake my law and walk not in my judgment. See, one of the things that cause us to be bound and burdened is we walk away from the covenant of the promises of God. And as a result of that, the enemy comes and he brings judgment. In other words, instead of us obeying the commandments and the statutes of God, we do our own thing. And as a result of that, the attacks of Satan comes. And when the attacks of the enemy comes, he can do what he wants to because we permit him to. Look at verse number 33. It says, nevertheless, my loving kindness will I not utterly take from him, nor suffer my faithfulness to fail. So even in all of that, God says, I'm still with you. Even though you're burdened down, even though you're yoked down, even though spiritual attacks are coming at you from every direction, not only you, but your family, your children, your home, your husband, your wife, your fiance, or whoever it may be, the attacks of the enemy is working and in operation. But if you go back to God and repent and stay with him, he'll give you victory. Let us pray. Now, Father, in the name of Jesus, we give you glory, honor, and praise. We bless you now for this word. We thank you for anointing it by the power and the authority given in the mighty name of Jesus. Now, Father, we repent unto you for allowing the enemy to yoke us down with strongholds, demonic forces, and attacks. We repent to you for walking away from you and for not obeying your voice and for not doing what you've instructed us to do. And we ask you, Father, to forgive us. And we ask you, Father, to break the yokes and pray this prayer with me of the enemy off of me. Break every spiritual attack. You'll feel the breaks, the yokes coming off because you've repented. And yield me. Help me to humble myself for your kingdom and for your glory's sake. Now, say, Satan, I release myself from your strongholds in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Say, Jesus, there's power in your name. And your name is above every yoke of Satan. Say that. And say, Jesus, it's in your name that I asked to be free from the strongholds of the enemy. Take the fire of the Holy Ghost and burn every spirit that causes me to disobey your voice. Say that in Jesus' mighty name. Now, Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you for setting the captive free. And we thank you, Father, for releasing them now. We thank you that we replaced the yokes of the enemy with the anointing of the Holy Spirit, with the fire of the Holy Spirit, with the wisdom of the Holy Spirit, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We praise you for pouring your oil all over them now. In Jesus' mighty name, we decree and declare it. You said, decree and declare a thing, and it shall be. You'll feel yourself being set free. You'll feel the yokes being broken off of you now as the anointing of God is pouring upon you now. Holy Ghost. And we give you glory for it now, God. We thank you for setting them free now. And it tills in Jesus' mighty name. All glory and all honor, all power and all praise belongs to you now, Father. And we bless you. We adore you. We esteem you now. Now, Father, we activate this word. Every crevice, every crack, seed, root, and fruit. We seal it unto the day of redemption by the power and the authority given. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen and amen. It's Apostle Barry Spates. I want to take the time this morning to thank you so much for viewing this video, whether it's this morning or this afternoon, whatever time it may be. We praise God for you, and we just thank God for you. Now, we want to take the opportunity to invite you to accept Jesus Christ as our Lord and our Savior. Romans 10 and 9 says that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shall believe in thine heart that God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. St. John 3:16 says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. It says, God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. It is our job to build the army of God, and it is our job to fill up heaven and to empty out hell. This is my decree and my declare, that the sons and daughters of God will begin to decree and declare salvation across the video ways, across the airways, in their messages. And they'll begin to win more souls for the kingdom of God. For God is doing a new thing. America will never be the same. There's been a tremendous shift with this coronavirus. And we'll never go back to the way we once were, because God is continuing to shift and is continuing to move us a new way and do a new thing. So he gets the glory, the honor, and the praise. Now, with that being said, I want to lead you to Jesus. Now say, Father, in Jesus' name, I confess with my mouth, I believe in my heart that your son Jesus was raised from the dead for my sins and my iniquities. So I confess my sin. I repent of my sins, all ungodliness, all unholiness, and all unrighteousness. So I receive Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior in Jesus' name. If you just said that, you are now saved. Now get into a Bible-believing church. Get into the Word of God. Begin to read your Bible so the Lord can begin to fill you. You may fall, you may err, and you may make mistakes, but at this moment, you are now saved. And continue to repent for your sins and your iniquities. This is Apostle Barry Spates for Barry Spates Ministries. I want to take the time to ask those of you that would like to send letters of appreciation and donation. You can send them to Barry Spates at P.O. Box or Apostle Barry Spates at P.O. Box 38, Clemens, North Carolina. That's Apostle Barry Spates or Barry Spates Ministries. P.O. Box 38, Clemens, North Carolina. That zip code is 27292. Or you can cash out me at Barry Spates. Or you can send me an email at barryspates@gmail.com. That's barryspates@gmail.com. Once again, thank you so much for viewing this video. God bless you, and especially you. Bye now.